Welcome to our channel. Still we are in the series of revising KCSE chemistry paper 120. So here question 19. You are told here you have 6.2 grams. This is 6.2 grams of phosphorus was reacted with excess oxygen. So mark that excess oxygen to form or to get phosphorus 5 oxide. Now the question is asking determine the mass of the oxide formed. So we need first, we need to write the equation for that reaction. So you have phosphorus that is solid. It's going to react with excess oxygen. That's here. So the product that you are going to form here is phosphorus 5 oxide because you get excess oxygen here. So phosphorus 5 oxide. That is a P2O5 there, which is solid there. So here you are going to get phosphorus 5 oxide. Now for you to balance that equation, then one thing you need to note that is that here you put 4. Here you put 4 and then here you put 2. So now oxygen here becomes 10 here. So here you put 5 here. So the mole ratio here, that's very important. The mole ratio for this reaction is that here you have 4 is to 5. I mean here you have 4 is to 5 is to 2 here. Now having done that, the next step is you calculate the number of moles for. You calculate number of moles in 6.2 grams of phosphorus. And for you to calculate number of moles, you should use this formula. You say mass divided by molar mass. Now the mass that you are given here is 6.2. So 6.2 divided by, what is the molar mass of phosphorus? So the molar mass of phosphorus is that one here. So that's now 6.2 divided by that one there. Therefore, if you do the calculation here, you will get 0.2 moles there. You will get 0.2 moles there. So that's another second step. Now, that step, what you need to do is that you have now the mole ratio. The mole ratio is the number of moles that react now. So here, you have phosphorus, the mole ratio here is 4, and then that of phosphorus 5 oxide, that's another product, is 2. So what is the mole ratio here? So the mole ratio of phosphorus to that of phosphorus 5 oxide is 4 is to 2. So the mole ratio is 4 is to 2. So what does it mean here? It means that this ratio, this 4, represents which number of moles? It represents 0.2 moles. So now, if you want to calculate now the number of moles of phosphorus 5 oxide, then you will say now what about 2? Right? So now, it will be 2 times 0.2 moles divided by 4 there. So if you do that calculation now, the number of moles of phosphorus 5 oxide will be 0.1 moles there. It will be 0.1 moles there. Now, from there now, because the questioner is asking mass. Questioner is asking mass of phosphorus 5 oxide. So, for you to calculate now mass, you will say mass is equal to number of moles times what? Times molar mass. So, you already have the number of moles here, which is now 0.1 moles. Now, how do you get number? I mean, how do you get molar mass? So, the molar mass of phosphorus 5 oxide is, you get it from the formula now, that is P2O5. So one phosphorus is 31. So because you have 2, it will be 31 times 2 there. So 31 times 2 so that now will give you 62 there. And then because you have one oxygen is 16. So one oxygen is 16 there. So here is the molar mass of oxygen there, 16. So 16 now times 5 here. Therefore, that one I will give you it. So that one I will give you 8 there. So now you sum up there. So it will be 8 plus. So the molar mass now of phosphorus 5 oxide will be 142 there. So now here you come and say 0.1. Times, which is number of moles, times the molar mass, which is 142 there. So if you do now that calculation, so the mass of phosphorus 5 oxide that's from there is 14.2 grams. So that's now how you go about it. So next you have question 20 there, which says compound V. So here we have compound V that reacts with water, as shown in the following equation. So here you have V reacting with water. So what do you get here? Look at this. So here you have OH here. So this is now an alkanol. So what type of an alkanol is it? An alkanol is an organic compound that contains a hydroxyl as the functional group. So here we have hydroxyl here. So if you want to get the name, then it will be how many carbon atoms do you have here? So here is one carbon atom. Here is the other carbon atom. And then here you have that carbon atom here. So an organic compound that contains three carbon atoms, then it's called prop. Prop. And therefore, because this is now an alkanol, therefore the name will be propanol. So the name now will be propanol. So which organic compound that you are going to react with water so that you get an alkanol here? Therefore, that one should be an alkene. So note that usually, when you react an alkene, there's an I double bond, you react with water, right? So this is not the general equation, usually you will get an alkanol, you will get a corresponding alkanol here. You will get a corresponding alkanol there. So this one now should be what? Should be an alkene. So which alkene? Because here we are getting propanol, then the alkene now that you are going to get here will be the corresponding alkene, which is propene. So the name of V now, so V now is what? So V is a propene. So V is a propene. Now what is the chemical formula of propene? Prop means three. So here you have three carbon atoms. Three carbon atoms. And because the general formula of an alkene is CnH2n. So the general formula of an alkene, that is, sorry, we have CnH2n. So because the number of carbon atom is 3, then the number of hydrogen will be what? It will be 3 times 2, which is 6 now. So that's another formula of alkene. So you draw now this one. So how many carbon atoms are you going to draw? So you are going to draw 3 carbon atoms here. So that's another 1, 2, 3 there. So the double bond will be here. Let us say the double bond will be here. So here now, you put a bond there. Then here, you put a bond there. Then from there, now you distribute the number of carbon atoms. So here you have hydrogen here. Here you have hydrogen. 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 So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we say the name here is what? The name here is propene. Now, other than use of catalyst, name another condition necessary for this reaction. Now, the name of this reaction, first you call it hydration, or you call it addition of water, or you can call it oxidation. Now, for that reaction to occur, the catalyst which is required here, the catalyst that's required here is called phosphorus 5 acid here. The catalyst that you use is called the phosphorus 5 acid there. That is H3PO4. Now, other than phosphorus 5 acid, what are the conditions required? So you require, one, you require temperature. So you require a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius. So we require that temperature. Now, other than temperature, you also require a pressure of 60 to 70 atmospheres here. That is 8 m. So what did he say? So he said this reaction is called hydration, or you call it addition of water, or you also call it oxidation. So for that now to occur, there are three conditions required. One, a catalyst of phosphorus 5 acid. You require a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius. And then you also require a pressure of 60 to 70 atmospheres. Now, question C. This type of reaction is called hydrolysis. So we also call it hydrolysis or hydration state, another name that can be used to describe the reaction. So this is a reaction, we can also call it addition. We also call it oxidation. And that is the end of our session for today. Thank you. Keep on subscribing. More are coming.